ShivPrasad, who is the director of the Nehru Science Centre. Thank you, sir. Wonderful to have you with us.
It's a pleasure.
So you're participating in the Vigyan Samagam, and it's the first venue.
Yes.
Yes. So how's your participation?
We're very excited about it. Basically, the science normally in most of the countries,
right,
they always feel that it is for some elite few and those working in the glass houses.
Right.
But then taking the message of science to the common man,
absolutely,
is something which is the need of the hour.
Sure.
And this exhibition, the Vigyan Samagam, expressly aims at doing that. These are seven fundamental science research projects which have an international collaboration, about which you have heard extensively.
Right.
All these seven projects and the researchers, scientists who are working on these projects, they have all collaborated with the funding from the Department of Atomic Energy and the Department of Science and Technology. And there will be one exhibition in single place covering all the seven mega science projects. And what we as a partner are doing with the Atomic Energy and the DST is that how do we take this exhibition to the common man? Common man includes, you know, in most of the countries, particularly in India, the public funded institutions are the ones who are involved in this. This is the Atomic Energy or the DST, who are the major funders for this project. And the public funding means public has to be informed about what the projects are. So the Science Center primarily is aimed at reaching out to as many people as possible. And the Nehru Science Center reaches out to about 800,000 visitors annually.
Wow,
that's a great number. Yeah. Out of these 800,000, close to about 300,000 are school students. These mega science projects, like in the interview you must have heard Mr. Srivastava telling you, they have a gestation period. Because they have about 8 years, 10 years, 15 years of gestation period. When we talk about these projects and what these projects envisage, what fundamental research goes into these projects, when we talk about this to the students, they actually can have a choice career. Who knows, they could perhaps one or two or 10 of them could actually pursue this as their career. So besides going and reaching out to the students and the public, the industry, everyone, the whole society or the stakeholders who are responsible indirectly in funding these projects, we are taking this message of mega science or Vigyan Samagam to those people.
So what are your other activities at the center?
Well, Nehru Science Centre is part of one institution known as the National Council of Science Museum. We have about 25 science centres and museums spread across the country. Our primary objective is to create awareness about science, creating scientific temper, enhancing the understanding of science in a non-coercive manner. Most of the formal education system, there is a coercion. In the sense, you have an exam to write. Here, their understanding is non-coercive. Nobody is going to assess them what they have learned. They can learn at their own pace in an interactive manner and enhance their understanding. Primarily in science, according to me, it is the enhancing the understanding of science that is more important rather than the marks.
So what's your strategy?
Our strategy,
yes.
For example, the science, Vigyan Samagam is something which we are talking about the mega science project. But if you have a look at this science museum here, we have different galleries and exhibitions on various topics. The latest one which we have added last year is an exhibition called as the Machine to Think. We are talking about the fourth industrial revolution, the so-called fourth industrial revolution, where all the Internet of Things, everything centering around Internet and what kind of this revolutionary scientific benefit that's going to accrue to the society, something what we have done. So children can come, learn about this technology, how does this Internet of Things or the fourth industrial revolution going to play a pivotal role in society. So they come and understand that, they learn that in a non-coercive manner. So each of the galleries that you have is all interactive. And then there are n number of lectures that we have, demonstrations that we have, which excites the children.
All throughout the year.
Yeah.
So you have exchange programs with the school? And
we have extensive, in fact, all the schools in Mumbai.
Yeah.
I'm sure they must have visited the Science Center in one or the other. We have about 1200 plus schools who visit us.
So technology is always evolving. So
yes.
What innovative things are you
doing? Innovative thing, if you really have a look at about Facebook,
yeah,
you know, we always try to create an awareness about what's happening here, and then fairly good amount of information is available on this. And then we also have a small little Twitter account, we have social, through social media also, we want to reach out to the people. And this event, you know, especially the first two day seminar, since we have a limited capacity in the auditorium, we are going to ensure that all the lectures will be put on the YouTube of the Nehru Science Center.
that will amplify the message.
Yes.
So what is your message for the students? And
student is something, these are exciting days, you know, like for example in the early, what you call the 1890 to 1905, the golden era of physics, you know, that revolutionized what we are benefiting from the technologies, whether it's a mobile or any technology. It all happened from the understanding the fundamentals of science. The seven project that we are talking about is going to shed new light into the discoveries. These new lights are the ones which are going to rule the nation for the next 50 years, not only India, globally. And those people, those children who want to pursue career in this, it's an exciting time for them.
So what's your philosophy here?
My philosophy is to reach out, take science to the doorsteps of everyone.
Absolutely. More power to science.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Pleasure.
Thank you.